Subscribe Tryst with Vanilla Girl and tap the bell icon to get notified for all the uploads on this channel. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is me, Radha, and you're watching me on my YouTube channel, Tryst with Vanilla Girl. So today I've come up with yet another beauty haul from a new skincare brand, that is SaND for Soapaholics. So the brand is not new, although I am new to this brand. So I happened to try first product of this brand, that was a soap, a monkey bar, and it was part of my April or I guess May fab bag. I quite liked the product quality. It quite reminded me of Lush products. So that intrigued me and I started researching about the brand. So SaND for Soapaholics is a Bangalore based beauty brand, and the brand owner Sangeeta has worked with Lush Cosmetics once they were in India. So that actually quite reflects in the product preparations and their overall look and feel. I've hauled for skincare, hair care and body care products for myself from the brand, plus I've got a couple of freebies also. Let's get started with the video. I hope you'll enjoy watching it. Starting with the haul, all the creamy products that I've received are packaged in these golden plastic jars, which have got a plastic stoppers inside the lid just to prevent the product to, you know, ooze out and make the packaging travel safe. So starting with the first product, I have picked up a facial cleanser for dry skin, and it is Totally Peanuts face cleanser. Now it has got kaolin and pink clay, which quite reflects in the color of the product, which is kind of has got this reddish tinge. Now texture is slightly granular because it has got the powdered peanuts that offers really nice exfoliation. So I've used this product just for once and as of now, and I really love the preparation. It smells really nice. I can smell patchouli and peanuts. The peanut powder in it offers really gentle mild exfoliation, and it has got honey, which is quite nourishing because it's an actually a humectant, so it helps to replenish the lost moisture from your dry skin. Next, I have picked up these two jars of roses and oats hand and body cream. So I have never used a product that has got roses and oats together. Usually oats come with either honey and roses come with geranium, so I was quite thrilled for this common mixture. So I picked up these two jars. So this is a creamy preparation that actually smells like roses. It's very lightweight, and I just take small amount of the product over here and show you that it just spreads easily on my skin, gets absorbed within seconds of massage without leaving any greasy residues, and it leaves my skin delicately fragrant, which I absolutely love. So it has got a goodness of glycerin, rose flower, wheat germ seed, all of them, they are known as skin nourishers. So I'm quite looking forward to use this cream as soon as possible. Let's see if these products make their way to my monthly favorites also. Next, I've picked up this face mask from the brand, that is Leela. So I quite like the subtropical Indian continent name of this mask, that is Leela. So it has got mango fruit and curds with kaolin, honey and primrose, avocado, butter of mango kernel. All these products, they are known as great nourishers for dry skin. Now as far as the texture is concerned, it looks lot like a souffle, so mixture of a mango and clay. So unlike regular clay mask, it doesn't gives you a uniform clay like, you know, spread on your face, because it has got other oils also. So it seems like as if you are actually putting a butter or a souffle on your face. So it leaves my skin extremely nourished. It glows from within. I don't feel the need of moisturizer immediately because it nourishes my skin deeply. So I am quite enjoying it. I've recently shared my top 5 favorite facial masks for dry skin, and I think this is one more a recommendation because I'm absolutely loving using it, and be seeing more of this in my future videos also. That was for skincare. In my hair care, I've picked up these two products. So first one is this SaND for Soapaholics Minty Blue Liquid Shampoo. I quite love the color of this shampoo to begin with. Personally, I am a huge lover of cooling products, especially for my hair care. So I assume that this is going to apply with this cooling sensation, and the ingredient list is really impressive. It has got linseed, vitamin E, honey liquid. So basically I looked out for the products which are meant for dry skin and dry hair. So I'm not sure that how this is going to work, but right now with the color and the ingredient list, I'm quite thrilled to use it. Another product that I've picked up for myself from SaND for Soapaholics is this Henna powder, which is named as a virgin mix. Along with Henna, it has also got another herbal products like Bhringraj, indigo leaf, Brahmi, and Azodari rhizome. So actually you're supposed to mix this powder with a hot tea or coffee decoction, and then you just make a paste and apply it all over your hair. So is it going to color my hair, and how it conditions my hair? I have yet to test it out, and I'll be sharing my experience with these two products soon, either in any of my videos or on blog. So stay tuned. And last but not the least, I've got these two freebie products from the brand. First one is this lip balm, that is Lips Don't Lie Saffron, and I quite like the texture of this balm, which is quite lightweight. It is deeply nourishing and doesn't color your lips, but it has got this really nice saffron like spicy fragrance, which I absolutely adore. So this is one of its kind in my collection. Another freebie that I received is this bathing soap, and the name of the soap is And a Bit of Tenderness. Further, it has got buffalo milk, honey, jojoba oil, bentonite clay, and I'm quite excited to use this because these bars quite remind me of Lush bars that I absolutely adore. So this is how this one looks, and it smells really nice, really nice. That was all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed watching it. Do leave me a comment if you have tried any products from SaND for Soapaholics and how was your experience with it. So please do give thumbs up to this video if you really like it, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I will see you soon in my next video. Bye bye.